12th Standard Maharashtra State Board. Board Exam 2020, the English paper. Here we go, my friends. First, the paper pattern and time management. Well, it's an 80 marks paper to be done in 3 hours. Let's see the paper pattern quickly. 1A, scene passage, 12 marks, 15 minutes should be enough. It's a scene prose passage from your text. 1B, grammar for 3 marks. Well, 5 minutes should be enough. So here we end with question number 1. Moving on to question number 2. Scene passage again from your text for 12 marks, 15 minutes. And 2B, you have a guided note making. What's a guided note making? We'll talk about that, right? 3 marks, 10 minutes maximum. Moving on from here, and we go to question number 3. Well, 3A is your unseen passage. This is not from your textbook. 12 marks, that's why you can time yourself at 25 minutes here. And 3B is a guided summary or a preci. But yes, guided. Again, guided. Yes, you will be given the points which you will have to expand into a paragraph. 3 marks for that, maximum 10 minutes. Extremely scoring paper. 45 marks done. Let's look at question number 4. Scene poems. 8 marks, 15 minutes should be enough here. Question number 5. 2 rapid reading passages. 5A and 5B. 4 marks each, 10 minutes each should be more than enough. Question number 6. A is letter writing for 4 marks. Yes, you will have a choice of letter here. B is leaflet versus report writing for 4 marks, 10 minutes for each letter writing, leaflet or report. C is information transfer versus view, counterview. Any one of the two, 4 marks, again 10 minutes, which leaves us with question number 7A, interview writing for 4 marks, 10 minutes, and question number 7B for 3 marks, again 10 minutes. Finally, review, recheck, 15 minutes. So here we are, 80 marks in 180 minutes. Now, what are we going to do here? In this module, I'll cover up section number 1, that is the 45 marks for prose, both seen and unseen. Let's go into the details. Question number 1A, it's a scene prose extract from units 1 to 4, around 250 words for 12 marks. Now, the 6 different questions will be, the first question will be a complex factual or a global understanding. Activity number 2 will be inference or interpretation. Activity number 3, conclusion or guessing. Yes, so this is going to be a bit open-ended. Activity number 4 is vocabulary. Activity number 5, again a bit open-ended, the personal response question. And activity number 6, contextual grammar. So you have 4 marks for vocabulary and grammar in each and every passage. That makes it 4 threes are 12, because there are 3 passages, 2 seen and 1 unseen. Moving on, non-textual grammar, 3 marks. That's 1B. Now, if you look at question number 2A, it's a scene extract from units 5 to 8, around 250 words, and exactly the same questions as question number 1A. A1 is complex factual global understanding, A2 inference interpretation, A3 conclusion guessing, A4 vocabulary question, A5 the personal response question, and A6 the contextual grammar question. Again, 2 marks each, all 12 marks. Question number 2B is an unseen extract selected to form the basis for your guided note making. Approximately 200 words, right? Now, you have to go ahead and look at the next one. That is question number 3. Again, question number 3A. Now it is an unseen extract, around 250 words, but the questions are the same as question number 1A. Same 6 questions, 12 marks, and question number 3B is a summary based on the extract in question number 3A. So the same extract, but it is a guided summary for 3 marks. Let's have a look again at the 6 types of questions. Activity 1, complex factual, global understanding. Oh, sir, you're being repetitive. Okay, activity 2, inference, interpretation. 3, conclusion, guessing. 4, vocabulary. 5, personal response. And 6, contextual grammar, 2 marks each. Now, as you can clearly see, vocabulary and grammar together make up 15 marks in the paper, right? And we have a lot of vocabulary and grammar topics. We shall see them in the next module along with section 2, which is poetry.